All right, 40 miles from home, and I think I found a great place to take a little hike. Got my gear, my dirty old car, and as you can see, there's a road right there. This was a really hard trailhead to find. It's not the main trailhead, and there's the path I'm going to start on and see where that takes me. I'm just west of Hell, Michigan, and only a few miles from Half Moon Lake in Michigan. This thing's weighing right in at 65 pounds. I overpacked for sure, but I've got a lot on the agenda over the next day and a half, because it's already 7 o'clock at night. So let's get this party started. I might have just found my spot. All right, well, good morning. I think I got my mic set working, my digital recorder that I thought I had lost. I didn't think I lost it, I thought I'd left it. Turned out I brought it. Had a beautiful night. A little chilly. Fireworks were going off until about 1 a.m. About when everybody settled down with the fireworks. It's got a little bit quiet, or as quiet as the woods. I mean, this is quiet for the woods. That's noise I can take, though. Anyway, slept in the hammock, bug shield, tarp. Didn't bring a blanket. Got up, I don't know, 4 in the morning or something. Threw this stuff on. Put my little smog on. And, this is actually my pillow, but I had to use my pillow to get, stay cold, warm. All right, so what we're going to do right now is go get my bear bag before hikers find it and eat my food. All right, so let's go get that bear bag before a hiker eats it. Obviously, somebody's camped here before. Look at that view over there. Beautiful lake. All right. Well, the the whole idea of a bear bag is to put your food up away from your campsite. Bears can smell that food, and you don't want them to smell the food and come get it and take it from you. Now, I've heard 100 feet, I've heard 300 feet. Honestly, oh, I ate a bug. Breakfast. Honestly, I don't know what is an appropriate distance, but I look at it like this. How far do I want the bear from me, right, while I'm sleeping? Oh, there it is. I passed it up. I put a marker up. Somebody must have knocked my stick down. All right, so Tac-Bar ammo can. What a great bear bag, right? And for protection, we put it in a bunch of poison ivy. And I didn't know that because it was dark. I hung that up about midnight. There we go. All right, I like this setup here, the tarp and the hammock. I like this configuration here for times when you know it's not gonna rain. So there wasn't a chance of rain, but I just wanted to cover myself up for what falls off the trees. Things come down off the tree and bugs and everything, and I wasn't really gonna be able to stare at the stars. So in a situation like this, I just rather have some type of cover, a little bit of shelter. I like this rather than, because it gives me the length of the corners, and it's above. I don't know if I'm gonna move over here so you can see a little bit better. All right, so you can see while I'm laying in that hammock, I can see all around me. And yes, you can see through that bug shield. And you can even shine a flashlight through it while you're in there and see perfectly fine. And I like that because things go bump in the night. There's noises out here. Things get to walking around you. And you kind of want to see what's going on. So, you know, you turn on the flashlight and point it out. And this gives you the ability to see what's around you. Excuse me. So, if this had been down, tarp to the ground, I'd have been staring at the, you know, at the side of a tarp, wondering what in the world was getting ready to eat me. And if there had been a risk of rain, now had there been a risk of rain, I would have raised this up, the tarp, tightened, and it's real loose right now. I'd tighten up this ridge line. I would have probably used this for the strength, went ahead and did it the way it was designed, and raised it up and still kept my my ends well above the line of sight, because I like to see what's going on around me. Now this here is just a mess. Okay, so I got in here right at the edge of dark, and I was pretty much putting the shelter, the tarp, up in the dark with a headlamp, and I think I might have got the hammock up before it got completely dark. We're talking about, it must have been like 9:30, 10 o'clock last night. So I didn't have a lot of time, but this normally shouldn't look like this. Plus I got up in the middle of the night and started digging for stuff when I was getting cold last night. But I like to keep my my gear up off the ground. Here's a prime example. That's an amp. I don't want to say farm, but I guess it's an ant farm down there. The carpenter ants eating this tree. So I like to keep my bag up off the ground. And these little bungee cords do the trick. So this one here is just wrapping around a tree to grab my frame. If I had an internal frame or even one of my packs without a frame, I'd have just went to the grab handle and lifted it up. That's pretty heavy. It's a 65-pound pack. But I normally like to have it up a little higher than that. But that's such a big tree. And to get that cord way up there and lift that pack up while I was dropping it, it was getting a little tough. And I thought, well, as long as it's off the ground. So, but normally I would have it covered as well. So in here I keep there's no sense in digging that out of there. But there's inside I have a rain cover for that, and it's actually large enough to drape over that whole entire setup right there and keep it all dry. Alright, I need some water. And I think that Tac-Bar box is going to come in handy again. Alright, so it's almost 7 in the morning. I'm sure hikers have already gotten started, and I'm not very far off the trail. You can easily see my camp from the trail and see that nobody's there, so I don't want to come back to all my gear being missing, but need some water. And there's access, lake access, about a quarter mile away. Even though I'm right off the lake, I'm not trying to walk through all that stuff to get to it. So here's my bucket. That's just steam lifting off of that water. It's not a toxic waste pool. Alright. I should have brought my headband for the camera, for the GoPro. Those are my aqua tabs that come with the Tac-Bar kit. We'll be using those. Got a little fishy down there. Alright, get us some water here. Try not to stir it up. Don't want a bunch of dirt in there. Probably enough. Alright. Didn't even get my feet wet. Good deal. I'm gonna hurry up and get back before somebody finds my stuff. Alright, let's see what we got here. How much? I had to strain that, but that's about, I have no idea. And I want to put a couple of water purification tablets or treatment tabs in here. Alright, so with me. Of course, I wasn't prepared here. Looks like there's two tiny little tabs inside of each packet. There's one. I don't want to overdo it because there's probably bleach or something in there. smart guy would have read that package of directions that came with that. All right, so we'll let that dissolve on our way back to camp. So there's our water, Tac-Bar container. I'm gonna show you what this thing comes with. Doesn't come with that, that's mine. Oh, I forgot the food. Oh, I'll have to go get the, well, actually I showed it too. But it comes with this little Tac-Bar tactical food, or no, it's a little survival kit, a little survival tin. So little razor blades. This is a pretty cool multi-tool. I've actually used this a couple of times since. Waterproof matches, a candle. Some fishing line, some fish hooks, oops, and some weights, and a couple, even a little lure there, ferro rod, an emergency blanket, and even though I have this stove set up here, I thought I'd go ahead and see if I can actually put a fire together with this thing. I think I might need this. First thing we're going to need is something to burn. And it looks like we got some stuff right here. Actually, stuff's really, really rotten, won't burn very long. One of the things about the early morning like this is, everything's still a little damp. Things haven't had time to dry off yet, so this might be a little tricky. I need something a little better than that, though, I know that. Now, obviously, I have knives and stuff. I just want to see if this stuff works. See if we can get enough use out of this survival kit. You know, it comes with five Tac-Bars, food rations, 2,500 calories. It's good for a day. And it's got a 5-year shelf life. Let me get this thing off of me. And I keep three of those in my 72-hour pack. It's just so easy just to take care of the nutrition and calorie count by just throwing a couple or three Tac-Bars in a 72 hour, because it's a 3-day pack. But it solves the trouble of the whole ramen noodles and mac and cheese and all that kind of stuff. What we're doing here is feathering this. Oops. It takes a little practice, but What we're trying to do is trying to expose as much of this meat of this little stick as we can, so that it'll catch, it'll take. See what I want to try to get the stick to catch. And this will help the, normally I would do it a lot more than that, but I gotta get my coffee going. Man, I suck. These are some pretty cool matches, though. I've actually never used these before. So I had all this stove kit. Oh, get off of there. My cook kit, and I wasn't at risk of not being able to get my coffee, but we don't want to make everything so easy. You don't learn like that. You're not always gonna have camp stove. I want to get this away from that. Let's see, as good a spot as any, I guess. Gonna get our water here and strain it through this bandana. Thank you. can't seem to keep everything out of the dirt. This looks pretty clean, doesn't it? The tablets and the bandana. I don't want to make that wet. Like that. Alright, well, that the cup was a little too warm after heating it, but I have this other one, but the water tastes fine. I don't even taste any of the iodine or bleach or whatever's in those tablets. I don't even taste it. But I will tell you, that Folgers instant, wow, is that gross. All right, now let's try this. These tack bars are vacuum sealed in Mylar bags, so that's where they get the 5-year shelf life from. And we're gonna break one open right now and get it started. So The way I like to use these is I like to break them into thirds, and that's actually how they're already set up. So there we go. So you can't really see it, but they're already actually I broke it in the wrong spot, but they're already broken up pretty easy. All right, so I mean, I got almost half of it here, but you know, it's fine. I've had them before. They're not bad. I mean, I've actually had the worst candy bars, to be honest. It's not like in a ballpark and having hot dogs or something, but it's not a Friday fish fry. But for what it is, it's doable, right? And it gives you the calories that you need to maintain out here. And honestly, 2,500 calories, just not even going to get you over with a whole lot of exercise, a whole lot of work. Alright, it was a little too hot to. Oh, good God! Oh my God, I almost fell. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Ah, looking more. Oh my God, oh. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Alright. Mm-hmm.